please sit down. May I request your attention, please? It's my privilege to invite Dr. A. Krishna Mohan Garu onto the dais. Welcome, sir. I request Ms. Yashaswini to hand over a sapling to Krishna Mohan Garu. It gives me immense pleasure to introduce Dr. A. Krishna Mohan Garu, Professor of CSE Department, University College of Engineering, Jawaharlal Nehru Technological University, Kakinada. He has 15 international publications to his credit and authored two books, Big Data and Analytics is one, and the other is Python and Machine Learning, which are very useful to computer science and the statistics students. He is the best teacher awardee twice in 2013 and 2016, apart from the best manager based on the performance of all the administrative managers in TCS when he worked in the Tata Consultancy Services. And he achieved a patent which is published named Accomplishment of Pay as You Go Approach on Entity Resolution for Data Integration and Data Privacy is a notable achievement by Sri Krishna Mohan Garu. And of course, he has around 6+ years of experience in industry, visited countries abroad like USA and Singapore, etc. He worked with MNCs like Fujitsu, Mastec, Cigna, Hartford Insurance, Citicorp, TCS, and Quest Diagnostic. He has 4+ years of management experience in administrative role and also awarded as one of the efficient managers in TCS. He has 13 years of teaching experience in reputed government university, Jawaharlal Nehru Technological University, Kakinada. He has expertise in big data, data mining, Hadoop, statistical analysis using R, Hadoop tools like Hive, Pig, and HBase. He's a resource person to train the faculty at various universities. He has expertise in the development of software using J2EE technologies like Servlets, JSP, EJBs, Structs, Spring, and web technologies like JavaScript, HTML, XML and XSL. He extensively involved in the designing object-oriented systems like using MVC architecture, Jakarta Structs framework, Spring framework, UML and Rational Rose, and IBM MQ series. With this, I am handovering this session to Dr. Krishna Mohan Garu to deliver his speech.
I have seen almost all the girls. The boys are very less. Why? The woman is moving forward. Women's strength is so much. Intellectuals and boys are looks like a little bit slow. Okay. Now, today, my session is on the future. The future means what we are going to do. Okay? So, from the long time onwards, you see the mankind. At the beginning of the mankind, have you seen the 300 movie, 300 BC? English movie? Okay? So, at the beginning, how the human being survived, how he grown up? He grown up in caves. And later, he used to find the fire and knows how to cook the food. At that time, it's a meat. And then he came to know the cultivation. And then it's going on. Now, where we are. Okay? So, there are so many generations went away. So many generations passed away. How many, the longest generation, whom you know? I'm asking you, the students, whom do you know the oldest man so far in your memory? Anyone? Okay. Anyone of you have seen your grandfather? Raise the hands. Grandfather. Okay, grand-grandfather. Grand-grandfather. Only three. Okay. Before to that, any generation? Okay. So how many generations has passed away so far? In front of us, how many generations has gone? Can you express? Or can you expect, give me an answer? So, how many years has passed away after the earth has came on? Almost so many million years. Okay? The generations has came and the science is growing up. So my time is, depends on how we survive in this world. This is the important thing that previously, when I was a kid, my father goes to a college, says that he studies BA, Bachelor's of Arts. Okay? So, the Bachelor of Arts means, at that time, he expects him to do a job on clerical way. Okay? Then, going on, if I come to my generation, the people works on the machines, on the computers. Going on. In the future, where you want to do? That is my question. Okay? So, this is the first generation. The first generation in science. It is manual labors. It is 18th and 19th century. Okay? Then second generation, mass production, manufacturing machines and process, it is late 19th and mid 20th centuries. Okay? At this time, the hydrogen bomb has invented, the physics has gone up to the peak levels. Okay? In the mid 19th century. Then, third revolution. This is analog and digital technology, internet and world wide web, globalization. This is the second half of the 20th century or early 21st century. This is where my education, my generation has grown up. Okay? So, let me tell you, people are looking like me, generation means the heroes are my father generation. The heroes are NTR and ANR. Okay? If anybody knows the NTR and ANR in this generation, how many of you know NTR and ANR? Okay. I grown up Chiranjeevi as a superhero and with him Nagarjuna and Venkatesh. Now, it's a new generation. In the same way, the third generation, I grown up in the third generation. Okay? Now, is the fourth, automation, analytics, and Internet of Things. This is early 21st century. Okay? So, you may get the jobs. If you wanted to do a job, you need to do in these technologies. You must learn these technologies, otherwise, you may not get the job. Okay, then what is the fourth generation? I'm telling you, what is the fourth generation of Industrial Revolution? This is Industrial Revolution. And what is this? What is its impact? What can be done? All these are artificial intelligence, robotics, automation, genetic engineering like bios. These are what I told you in the beginning. Just watch this slide once again. First Industrial Revolution is 1765 to 1840. They invented steam power, rise of the factory system, machine tools, chemical manufacturing, and iron production. Second Industrial Revolution is 1870 to 1914, rapid industrialization, electricity, telephone, rail, increased internet connections. Third Industrial Revolution, rise of electronics, microprocessors, telecommunications, and automation. Okay? So far, so many of the people here have seen the TVs maybe recently. After Rajiv Gandhi came into the power, Rajiv Gandhi came into the power in 1990s, I think. The people of India has seen the first TV at that time. Before to that, India doesn't see the TV technology. And this is the fourth Industrial Revolution. The fourth Industrial Revolution is so much. It is fusion of technology in the physical, digital, and biochemical domains, leading to the so many other technologies. Okay? So, in this thing, there are a lot of things to change. We need to change healthcare, and we have smart mobility, we have smart devices, and we have so many other things. These are the latest technologies that is going to rule the world. They are advanced robotics, big data analytics, simulation, augmented reality, digital integration, advanced manufacturing, cloud computing, and Internet of Things. Already in the market, there are so many applications has there in fire, in air quality, in radiation, urban mapping, and we have in water quality, water leakage, solar energy, development of projects. All these are already implemented, and so many companies are manufacturing all these devices, and it is came into the market. Okay? Nowadays, in Hyderabad, MS, and its cost is almost 1 crore. If you want to buy a home, a normal apartment, it is almost around 50 lakhs, but smart homes is around 1 crore. So why it is grown up to 1 crore is they have almost implemented all these technologies in their homes. Okay? Now, these are the, that we can see in the science. Very few are using these technologies on the right side. For head, for ear, for eyes, for body, and for everything, there are so many things came. Only we are using watches, wristwatches, right now here. But in US, the people start using all those devices. Okay, we are almost 50 years lagging behind compared with the Western countries. Okay, and all these on the right side technologies for health, all the technologies has implemented and having the applications. This is a automated car without driver. For example, it drives by itself. It is almost there in US. is running on the roads. And this is by the Amazon. This is also an automated van driven by without driver, and it takes all the goods to the destination. And this is one of the invention, and these are the some of the news in US. Okay, it diagnoses the diseases. If you give the whatever you want to do, if you put on online, diagnoses your disease. And there is for a last form, there is an application given by IBM. It was very famous. And this is Amazon in US taking all its things to through drones, delivering through drones. And what is the impact of this is so many people are losing the jobs. The Oxford University has lost almost 47-80% of jobs under 3 in 20 years, coming 20 years. Almost half of the current job activities can be automated. World Economic Forum says that a loss of 5 million jobs in the next 5 years. The International Labour Organization, 130 million South Asian workers could lose their jobs in the next 20 years. These are the news for how they lose the jobs. Foxconn replaced 60,000 factory workers with robots. And robots are doing so many other activities, robotic power. And percentage of global income. These are the poor countries on the left. On right side, 70% of the on the rich countries has so much growth. This shows that the poor countries are becoming poor and rich countries are becoming rich in the future. What we have to do is shorter working hours in the future, universal basic income, and education is a lot of impact, and we need to adapt. Okay. This is image for at the beginning of the first revolution. He is the leader who fought for the people against the science. They don't want the science to be increased. And it is called Ludit. His name is Ludit. Okay. Just as a glimpse, I gave you what is you are going to do in the future. Okay, what are you are reading right now is outdated. Almost whatever we are teaching in the my engineering college also is outdated, but we bring a new kind of technologies in the R19 syllabus. Okay, so don't think that whatever you are present here, I am telling you something which is unrelated to you. I am telling you the future, the changes, and how you need to adapt yourself. Okay, so if you don't adapt yourself, you are lagging behind, and you will be as like this, and you will be jobless for the future. So if you wanted to be a job holder, you have to learn the technologies that I am going to show you right now. Okay, watch this video just for 5 minutes. Later I will ask you the questions on this video. I will explain you each and every part of it. Okay? Just watch it and don't think that just even if you don't watch, nothing will happen. But there is a lot of things going to happen, and I will ask you the questions, and the guys who answered well will have the gift. Okay, dear friends, this is going in the so many foreign countries. Where are we right now? What are you reading? What are you learning? What are you doing? Tell me, anybody. Where are we? Are we going on pace with the world? Are we stopped here? Where are we? Okay. From the last third bench with a girl with spectacle, tell me the technologies that you have seen so far. Behind that girl with specs. Yes, you. Tell me the 9 technologies I have shown you in the video. What are those? And what do you know? Virtual reality. Okay. 1 minute. What she said is virtual reality. How many of you have experienced virtual reality? Raise the hands. How many of you have seen virtual reality or experienced virtual reality anywhere? Raise the hands. Anyone? Okay. The virtual reality is this. Have you anybody went to Kakinada beach for leisure show? Anybody has seen leisure show? No? The leisure show is, now it is spoiled. There is a picture comes here. And suppose if you wanted to show Modi, Modi will come stand here in 3D and he speaks. Okay? You think that it is real, but it is not real. He speaks that. That example is already there in virtual reality. So, if suppose you invited PM to this function or this seminar, he didn't come. In the future, what they do is, they send their files. Then you play here, he come here, he speaks with those files, and after the clip is over, he vanished. So that is going to come in the future. That is virtual reality. It's already there, and there are so many things came in, like you can keep some kind of things here, and you feel like you are in that world. No need to go for tours for so many countries. Just keep that, you feel like you are there. Okay? Those kind of things are coming very soon. One is virtual reality. What is next? Additive manufacturing. Okay, what is that? What is doing exactly? Come on, you have already seen the video. I told you, watch the video and answer me. What is that? The girl, can you tell me that, what is that? No? Okay. So then, what is the third? IoT. Do you know IoT? Is the teachers are teaching the IoT? By? Sensors. Okay. Have you coded any programs using IoT? Yes or not? Yes or no? You are very backward. So I think we are 50 years back, but it seems you are almost 60 to 70 years back. We have to learn all this. IoT is improved a lot, and some of my students have started a consultancy in Vizag for smart homes. Okay? So maybe you have seen at somewhere else, if you wanted to operate the water tank automatically, just call us. Have you seen those kind of advertisements anywhere or not? Not? No? Okay. Then I vote you. What is next? Big data. What is big data? Are you studying or not? Big data. No? Sorry, you are not teaching big data? No? Then we have to move forward. The syllabus has to change. What is big data? Tell me.
Discover something.
Discover something. No? See, you are daily using WhatsApp. Okay? So you are sending the message to where? Whom you are sending the messages? To some of your groups. Okay? And he is exactly receiving that. So per daily, how many messages you can send? Normally, 10 messages. Okay? So then a person sends 10 messages. Then how many people are using the cell phones in WhatsApp? Maybe Indian population is 100 crores, more than 100 crores. Can I say 50 crores are using it? Okay? 50 crores in India. And almost all the country, another 100 crores, 150 crores into 10 messages per day. How many messages? 1500 crores messages per day. And where are they storing? In a server. And if you wanted to retrieve in one day, out of 1500 crores messages, in the server, is it possible? Within the time, within fraction of seconds, you need to retrieve that message and give the user. Okay? And if it is 1 month messages, think that. Vast messages. How you are retrieving, how you are storing, how you are passing to other people. Everything is big data. Okay? It's Hadoop technologies. It's parallel processing. Okay? So the big data enters everywhere and it is serving. Okay? Third is big data. And what is next? Cloud computing. So are you learning cloud computing? Cloud computing is almost in the market from last 10 years, I think. Not 10 years, 6 to 7 years. How many of you are studying cloud computing? Raise the hands. Then what are you studying? Only C and Java? Okay. Cloud computing is nothing but the Amazon is once upon a time selling the books and it is a small company. Now they are earning millions of dollars per hour just to buy cloud computing business. How they are is, all the everything is they are giving on cloud. Suppose this college is having a lab. Okay, to set up the lab, they need so much of space, systems and everything. Nowadays, there is no need of it. Just you can get the space through cloud in that system. You can install the softwares, whatever you want. And you can do it from anywhere. The software is free, the space is free, the systems are free, but you need to pay a rent per month or per annum. Okay? So they are doing lot of business on that. Okay? So how many of you are doing the projects in cloud computing? Raise the hands. There are Amazon cloud service provider and Azure from the Microsoft and so many private cloud providers are there. And now we are running our, now I am the taking the website of J&T Kakinada right now. I am coding that. I am coding my website using and I am hosting that in the Amazon Web Services. Okay, in future we are going to see a lot of things. What is the next? Advanced simulation, where you can see these applications, where we can use this. Okay, suppose there is a cyclone is coming. Okay, we can identify what is the speed and other things. Through advanced simulation, we can find exactly how it is damaging the city. And I want to test my car driving at 80 miles speed or 100 kilometers per hour, and what it is going to damage. I don't want it to be damaged. Like that, there is advanced simulations came in and they give exact measurements. Okay, but testing the real things is the best. What is the next?
Autonomous robots.
Yes, robots. Have you seen the robots? Have you got the messages? Like, so many robots came in recently. In America has sent two robots as army to a country. Have you seen that news? On which country they sent? Don't know? Okay. There is a mission recently. America introduced two robots into the army. And their two robots gone into the enemy's area and almost it killed so many people and they came back. Have you seen the WhatsApp images of those two? No? You didn't receive? I have that. I received all of them. Okay. We have robots already into the market and there are a lot of robots has came into that. Okay? And the Rajinikanth movie, Robo, that is the very oldest technology. Now the technology has moved forward and robots can do a lot of things. Next. What is next?
Universal integration.
Universal integration means RFID. Okay? We give each and everything an RFID. Through that you can identify where it is. The RFID is each and every car is coming with RFID nowadays. You purchase a car, it comes with RFID. They can easily identify where it is with the RFID. Even the parcels, now they are keeping the RFID. There is a new technology that is already implemented. What is next?
Cyber security.
Cyber security, all of you know, the banks. Okay, you know all of them, it's one subject. What is the next?
That's all.
This all. Okay, let me tell you, my dear friends, these are the new technologies already in the market and going to rule in the future. All the software companies started giving the training on the some of these technologies already. Okay? So, all of you, if you wanted to do the jobs in future, you have to think where you want to be. Okay? So, I will show you once again this video. Please sit down. And I will ask you some more questions deeply. They taught us only arts. They didn't teach us the science. Whereas Western countries has a research in science and they are moving forward. Okay? Later, after British has gone, we are keeping studying the oldest things and we are like that. But the industrial revolution, what I am telling you, the fourth industrial revolution has came only in 1980s in India. Only software has exploded because the youth at US are not willing to learn those things, just they want to manage. And we are into the software field and the science started coming to India. Okay? Later, all these technologies, what I showed you is invented by Indians. Almost. In every research, there is an Indian guy. Either in space, either everywhere. Okay? So, the Indians are treated as most intellectual people. Just once again, see that in future, you have to learn any one of these technologies to get a job. Okay? I will go in depth into each technology. I'm going to give the teaching only in data analytics in software companies. I mean, expert in data analytics. But all the remaining things are almost in each and every software company, they start giving training in each technologies. Just watch that once again. This is also 3D printing. In somewhere we say that. Nowadays all the engines are 3D printing. All the car engines are in 3D printing. Everything is connected. This is my expertise. I did my PhD in this. Nowadays, if you go to Hyderabad, Tableau is one of the software which can use for this kind of things. So many people are using Tableau. This is RFID given to all the cars at the time of manufacturing. These are changing, the time is changing. Take in the movies, once upon a time, in movies, if an actor can tell the dialogues continuously for 5 minutes, he's the great. At that time, S.V. Rangarao, N.T. Ramarao, and A.N.R., they used to tell the dialogues for so many times, or lengthy time, they feel like he was the greatest actor. Later, it came to the dances. Chiranjeevi came and he danced very well. People think that who dances well and who fights well is the actor. Later, so many other people came and they show their bodies, six pack and other things. People think that any hero with six pack is the great actor. Okay, so the time is going on like this. What I'm telling you is, once upon a time, from the long history, the science is going on changing. First revolution of science, industrial revolution. Okay, people find the jobs after first industrial revolution. Then second industrial revolution came in. Then people start working on that, and the teachers like us start teaching them accordingly to the second industrial revolution. Then third industrial revolution came in, internet and all the things. We start teaching all the students about the third industrial revolution. People used to get the jobs. Now the fourth industrial revolution came in, but we are not taking the train yet. Okay? So almost IITs, MITs, NITs, they started and they booked tickets for their students, and teachers were trained in all these technologies. They start teaching all of them. But whereas the conventional colleges like arts and some of the oldest engineering syllabus colleges has not started taking the change or taking the adaptation. So my question is, when you are going to adopt, students, when you can change, tell me. If you don't change, you are unemployed. You won't be like that. The world is changing. When are you going to change? Who can tell me? Are you getting my ideas into your brain or not? Getting my ideas or not? So when you can change, you are thinking that regularly coming to the college and learning whatever the teacher says, one or two things, you will get the job. It is not going to happen in the future. The future is fastly growing, changing. You need to change. Then the teachers also, we are also need to change. Okay? So I'm concluding with my request to all the people. At least please change. Okay? Please remember by name. After you change, that sir has told us that to change as early as possible. Okay? Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity.
Thought-provoking lecture. Please come on to the dais, sir. I request conveners and all the guests and HOD physics, please come on to the dais and felicitate Dr. Krishnamohan, sir.